So Mike Nolan is Vice President of Sales for Siemens Rail Automation in North America. And Mike, tell us about the company. There's a tremendous history. It goes back more than 100 years, correct?
Yep. Siemens has been in the rail business for over 160 years, providing solutions for different aspects of the rail industry. I'm here today representing the rail signaling group, or mobility automation, but we also have a rail infrastructure group, which does electrification, all electrification needs for the railroad. We also have a rolling stock group based here in USA. In Sacramento, they make rolling stock for different transit and subway applications and light rail applications. And we also have an urban transportation group, the division that provides different levels of automation and tolling and traffic control for the urban traffic. And then finally, we have a customer services group that really wraps all of the different services aspect required by customers into one division.
So Mike, let's talk about Siemens grade crossing technology. In the background, we have the S60 gate mechanism, which looks like a traditional gate mechanism for people who are familiar with Siemens technology. But what's new about this?
So you're exactly right, Bill. I mean, a lot of people know us for our traditional crossings and predictors and these types of things. And this is our S60, which is our newest gate mechanism. But this includes a lot of new technologies. It's actually controlled by our GCP 3000 Plus, which is our newest grade crossing protector. And the real benefit of 3000 Plus is, like you said, we have a long tradition of products in the field. Siemens has been making these products for over 50 years. And we're here to support the railroads. But as this older technology gets phased out, we've developed a 3000 Plus as a complete drop-in replacement. So if a customer has older 20, 30-year-old technology, we're able to provide them with a drop-in replacement, same wiring, same screen, same things they're familiar with, but all new technology, new electronics. So now they can really go into an old crossing, 30 years old, and replace it with new technology in less than 90 minutes. So Bill, in addition to all of the grade crossing things we've talked about, we've also invested a lot in wayside equipment and wayside LEDs. Siemens' new wayside LED is not only more efficient, which everybody knows about LEDs, but it also has interesting features in it that are very helpful to determine light out. It also meets the color standards of ARIMA, which is very difficult to do for an LED.
So Mike, what we have here is a track circuit for electrified territory.
Absolutely. So this is really exciting new technology for Siemens. A lot of municipalities are putting electrified territory in. Electrified territory is a greener source of propulsion for trains. So being able to have track circuits that function in electrified territory is critical. So what we've been able to do is design a track circuit that works in electrified territory without any additional hardware.
And what we have here next to us is the Siemens Train Guard PTC OBU, which stands for onboard unit. Why don't you describe this onboard technology for us?
Sure. So this is a fully interoperable onboard unit developed in accordance with the specifications for major Class 1 railroads in the U.S. With respect to the FRA mandate to basically stop trains if they are overspeeding or going to overshoot various targets, work zones, misaligned switches. Our particular Siemens OBU is special in that it's a very ruggedized design, as you can see here, has full military connections, IP65 certified, so it's fully waterproof, dust sealed, all of that, and it's conduction cooled, so there's no fans in there to cool the unit or anything like that, so it can fully withstand the temperatures of North American rail locomotives.
So what we're looking at here is the cab display.
Yes, this is the display that's typically inside of a locomotive cab where the operator has information about his track speed, his maximum allowable speed based on either access or cab signal, and then his actual train speed, and indicators indicating whether the systems are operating or not. If this speed exceeds this number here, you'll get an alarm. And if he doesn't respond within a certain amount of time, the train will come to penalty stop, which is the safe part of the system's operation.
I'd be very surprised to see a train crew with a tablet computer like this. What is this? Describe it, please.
So we talked a lot about connectivity, right, Bill? We talked about assets. We talked about the EOT. This is about connecting the maintenance away, right? So your maintenance and way employees are out in the field. They have to call dispatch to get tracks blocked. The idea behind this TrainGuard PTC maintenance and way tablet is to allow the dispatch and your crews to have media connectivity, accurate connectivity, so that they can block the tracks safely, get work done more quickly.
So Rolf Gussmann is head of the Siemens Division of Traffic Control. And Rolf, railroads are trying to become more efficient with operating scenarios like precision scheduled railroading. How has Siemens addressed it?
Okay, yeah. Hi, everybody. Thank you very much for giving us this opportunity to show what we can offer to the market, especially in the North American market today. Siemens has addressed this issue by using some approach with software which acts on top of the train control systems and which guides the dispatchers in a way to take optimum decisions in the operation. So for this purpose, we're having our commercial off-the-shelf software product TPS, which is part of the Siemens portfolio right now, and this is strategically being rolled out right now for a couple of railroads. And we're supporting the dispatchers with a view which is quite detailed, as you can see over here. So we have a high precise runtime calculation which allows for a high precise prediction.
Mike, this trailer behind us is pretty cool. It's a training. It's used for training. It's pretty impressive. Tell us about it.
Thanks, Bill. Selling products is one thing to the rail industry, but this is a 24/7 business, and the customers constantly need support. They constantly need help in the field, and it's not always practical to go to a classroom central to some location. So it's really critical that we be able to provide support to the customers in the field, and that's the purpose of this trailer. We've got all of our products, multiple different configurations all set up to match the customer setup. We're able to provide this training right on site so we can help the maintainers, the field personnel, wherever they may be, so they're able to get the support they need wherever they might be.